Should I worry if email I send is marked as spam? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I got from someone who had a concern basically because of a threat from one of his recipients. A business I was working with told me that they sent my email address to spam because they didn't like what I was asking of them. Now I'm a smidge worried. If they added my email address to their spam filter, does that mean I'm somehow going to be pegged as a spammer in the larger internet world? I seem to recall that someone once told me that anytime someone clicks that a message is spam, it's a strike against you. Enough strikes and we're in trouble. I don't remember how many strikes he said it took to be in trouble, though. So, am I worrying about nothing? Or should I be doing something about it, if there's anything to do, that is? The answer is super simple. Do nothing. And the reason behind that answer, as it turns out, it's a very simple answer, but it has a very complex background. Spam filters, particularly the good spam filters, rely heavily on users marking things as spam. In a way, it's what I would call a form of crowdsourcing, where basically the actions and the opinions of a bunch of users build a database used to determine what is and is not spam in emails that are then received thereafter. Where your email is marked as spam and who is doing the marking has a lot to do with any potential impact on the emails you send in the future. Now, I gotta start with the obvious. To begin with, don't spam. Seriously, the single most important thing you can do with any email, individual, mailing list, discussion list, or whatever, to avoid being marked as spam is to, well, ensure that people want to get it, that your email is welcome. That means keeping it appropriate for whomever is going to get it. If you suddenly start flooding a list, or even a friend, with pictures of the grandkids, offers to purchase from the latest MLM, your opinions on the current state of, well, whatever, and that's not what the recipients expected or want, then yeah, you can expect your message to be marked as spam. So don't do that, okay? Now, where it's marked as spam turns out to be important. There are generally two categories of places where someone can mark something as spam. They can mark it in an email program like Microsoft Office, Outlook, Thunderbird, EM Client, and so on. These are programs that run on your PC to access your email. Or they can mark it as spam in an online email service like Gmail or Yahoo Mail or Outlook.com and others. These are the cases where you're accessing your email by firing up your web browser and going to one of those websites. The good news is we can pretty much rule out the first one as a problem for you right away. When someone marks a message as spam in a desktop email program, that information typically applies only to that individual and only on that specific email program and only on that specific computer. So the fact that it got marked as spam, nobody else knows. Nobody else cares. It's just that one individual. And yes, it's still useful for them, right? It's helping them filter out spam that's coming to them, but the information is generally not something that gets fed back to any of the other services, any of the other reputation holders. So really, there's nothing you can do about it, but there's also no reason to worry about it. Online is a slightly different story, but as it turns out, only slightly different. So using Gmail as an example, if I use its web interface, in other words, I've gone to gmail.com, and I mark a message as spam, then Gmail may take that as a mark against the sender that could eventually impact their deliverability, but only for other recipients on Gmail. For shared online services, then, that mark against you really applies only to that specific service. Get enough marks as spam from Gmail users, and the Gmail spam filter will probably start dropping your messages into the spam folder. but it won't affect Outlook.com users, Yahoo users, other email users. However, the spam filters are incredibly complex. Seriously, it's way more than is even, it's difficult to even comprehend all the different kinds of things that a spam filter takes into consideration when it's evaluating a message to determine whether or not it should be considered spam. Some of the things they look at are the content of the message, the reputation of the email service or server being used to send the mail, not necessarily your reputation, but the reputation, say, of Hotmail.com or Gmail.com as a whole. The timing. If you send a bunch of emails to a bunch of people all at the same time, then that is ever so slightly kind of sort of spam-like. The number of recipients on your email, and way, way much more. I mean, it's like I said, each of these individually has a very, very, very small impact on the ability of the spam filter to decide whether or not it's going to mark it as spam. It's the collection of all of these that come together that allow it to determine whether or not something is or is not spam. Now, it gets weirder because many of these services, again, using Gmail as an example, actually have what I would call personalized results. So, if someone marks your email as spam often enough, your email may be considered spam for them, not necessarily for other Gmail users. Even on a shared system like Gmail, spam filters can be different for each recipient. What Gmail ends up considering as spam for you might differ from what it considers as spam for me, because we consistently mark different things as spam. That means if one person marks your message as spam a bunch of times and others do not, Gmail might say, well, okay, this person thinks it's spam, so I'll just spam it for him alone. As soon as you start getting many reports from multiple different recipients, a more global algorithm is likely to kick in and consider filtering your message as spam for more people. However, things get worse. I use Gmail as my example because it really does have one of the best spam filters in the business. I've run all my email through it for years. Other services have spam filters of various levels of quality and capability, or in some cases, they have no spam filter at all. So everything I just described for Gmail might not happen on, say, Outlook.com, or happen to different degrees, or happen with different rules. If someone has email based on their own web hosting, their spam filters may do something entirely different. It's incredibly difficult to know. Now, one phrase you used I want to be very clear about: the larger internet world doesn't really exist when it comes to spam. There's no central repository. Yeah, there's blacklists here and databases there, but not all services use all of the blacklists, and not all of the blacklists are kept up to date, and so forth. So ultimately, when one person marks your message as spam, it may make it more likely that your email to that person will end up in their spam folder, make it very slightly more likely that your email to others using the same email service might end up in their spam folders, but it won't affect your ability to send email to anyone else at all. That's a very long explanation of a very simple answer. Two things: don't spam, otherwise, don't worry about it. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/20280. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.